the short end.
Ah, there you are.
All that stands between you and Whitechapel is the villain controlling the borough. Kaelok has demanded you settle the claim for territory in a gang fight.
His loss?
Here. I'm sure he can put this to better use than I can.
Oh, what's this, Greeny? Assassin Christmas.
Gather your allies.
Mr. Rexford Kaelok has agreed to your terms and waits for you at the Whitechapel train station. He's bet his train on the fight.
No Kaelok. No matter.
Attack!
Appears to be broken.
Oh well. At least we have a train now. It's not all bad.
Kaelok is dead. Whitechapel is no longer in the hands of the Blighters.
You now have the chance to join our ranks. We welcome all who would stand up to Starrick and his cutthroats.
Ah, you bastard! I'd rather throw myself to the tracks and run Bertha another mile for that doted ball bag.
Kaylock? He's left the station.
Mel! Hello, Fancy Pants. And who might you
I'm
two
Evie
be?
Fry, and this is my brother, Jacob Fry.
Pleased to meet you. I'm Agnes McBean.
A delight.
I thought I was getting a promotion. I suppose I'm out of work now.
Come work for us instead.
I won't bile your heat. You pay better than scraps?
Oh, I'm sure we can at least match that.
Then may I present to you Agnes and Bertha, Lady and Locomotive, at your service. I'll be in the next car.
A hideout on the rails? What an excellent idea.
Yes, it all worked out rather well. Now, I would like to follow up a lead on... Jacob? Is this serious?
I'm not doing anything until this gets fixed.
I believe I know someone who can help with that.
I knew you would, Greeny.
You know, a mite of money goes a mickle bit in this city. Think of the power of good you can do with the purse you bring. You talk of a store in London. Well, now's your chance. That there map shows who to speak to. Old friends, if you will. Give me a whiff of that sterling, and maybe you can save us all from... Having to lay down our knife and fork afore we're ready. Now, enough shop talk. Believe Mr. Green said there was someone he wanted you to meet.
you in a bit.
Don't try to get away from me!
Oh, blast them.
Alec, whatever is the matter?
I have been intercepting nothing but poppycock propaganda about soothing syrup and whatnot. No, I swear to high heavens, if Starek's monopoly continues...
Alec, I beg your pardon. These are friends of mine. Evie Fry and her brother, Jacob.
Alexander Graham Bell.
Linguist, inventor, and technical expert. Alec, I have something of a favor to ask you.
Can you fix this?
Oh, looks like the casing is cracked. Oh! Comes apart. I see. Could have used one of these to fit my fuses on top of Big Ben.
Alec is installing a new telegraph line for our Free Press
Association. To combat the Starek Telegraph Company. Now, if I can mend the fuses connecting independent lines from Big Ben, Starek will be weakened. Only, we are somewhat at a handicap. And... there. Oh, I've removed the mechanism, so it may work with your bracer.
I'll put it to use immediately.
Jacob, wait. Mr. Bell, allow me to help you with your fuses.
Oh, you will not find me too proud to accept Miss Fry. Oh, we can use my carriage, if you'd be so good as to hold the reins, though.
I'll take that.
I can help you.
Miss Fry, I am so glad you could assist me.
So, Mr. Bell, what inventions are you concocting?
I intend to develop a phonetic telegraph that does not just convey dots and dashes, Miss Fry, but the human voice.
Phonetic telegraph? Sounds a bit of a mouthful. You could just call it a telephone.
Telephone? How bizarre. Anyway, as I was saying earlier, the press has become entirely dependent on the Starek Telegraph Company.
Which is why Mr. Green has asked you to set up a free line.
Yes. What is more, other small independent companies have had their lines sabotaged.
Easy now.
And they have little means of finding any broken fuses, which are...
to be found on top of Big Ben.
Correct. Especially as one... a special government pass to get through the guards.
They will not be a problem. I'll repair the fuses. Lovely view. Set. Over there. That should do it.
Thank you very much, Miss Fry. I will now be able to continue with the installation of the new line.
If there's anything else I can do to help...
Certainly. Please do come and visit. I was toying with this device and have noted down the formula for you. It's not perfect yet, but by golly, it works.
Come on! Faster!
Hang on. Miss Fry. I was just showing Jacob the first message was received via the mended lines. Oh, you can keep the rope launcher, by the way. We've managed to procure another one for your brother. Excellent work. Thank you, again.
You're very welcome, Mr. Bell.
We can now defend the principle of impartial news and free speech.
Free is fair, but free and brief is far better.
Ha ha! Ah, Fry, such caustic wit.
And on that note, we must depart.
Oh, good fortune to you both. Call on me at any time.
Now that we've finished with that distraction...
Who is that?
Oh, you mean... you don't know?
Beautiful train you got here. Miss McBean was just telling me all about her. Name's Ned.
How do you do?
I won't take up more of your time. If you want to learn a thing or two about the finest transit systems in the world, you can find me at this address.
Let us return to locating the Peace of Eden.
We need to reclaim London from Starrick. Who are my targets?
It's not time for that yet.
I didn't come to London to hunt curios.
First understand the dance, only then become the dancer.
Oh, so you're taking over where Father left off.
Someone has to.
Evie, finding the precursor artifact will give us an insight into what the Templars intend. Jacob, I have information about Starrick's associates that should be of use to you. Here.
This soothing syrup has become the only medicine available in Lambeth. It bears the Templar Grandmaster's name.
About time for a visit to the doctor.
I don't see that cure arriving anytime soon.
And what exactly will you be doing, might I ask?
You know very well. Tracking down the Peace of Eden.
Enjoy your studies. I'll be out killing Templars.
Looking particularly lethal, Jacob.
Hello, Mr. Fry.
How's the old afternoon, Governor?
Oh.
need the districts to contribute some tin.
wonder why no one's taken you to medical college yet.
It's impossible. Starek's soothing syrup is made from the finest ink.
Get Starek's soothing syrup right here!
It's all he drinks. Your syrup is liquefying him. He's turning him simple-headed.
Now, look now. You are scaring away my customers. Why don't you bugger off or I'll give you something to remember me by.
Oh, you can't talk to me like that, you little gutterling.
What's all this, then?
Oh, sod off!
If you'll excuse me, madam. Tell me where the syrup originates.
All I know is they make a run each day between the gasometers and the asylum.
What's going on? Ear, what's happening?
come from?
What's happening over there?
I'll teach you a fucking lesson!
This doesn't concern you!
Must be done about him.
Let's go.
Thank you.
find out where that syrup is made, shall we? Tomorrow. The man in charge of the syrup distribution runs a fighting club at the foundry.
Thank you. must have hurt.
Come on, you blooming Lushington!
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Where's the syrup, mate? Speak now or forever hold your...
The distillery. It's the large building beside the brewery.
Now, to stop soothing syrup production once and for all.
You had that!
Never again, I swear.
Right.
Fuck!
something of interest here.
Quiet on the backs of your neighbor. We must free ourselves from this ivory tower. We must find them.
Keep a sharp eye out, lads. Someone's targeting our network. The distillery might be next.
This will complicate things.
Thank you.
You should not go about frightening respectable gentlemen, young man.
I didn't realize snooping around was considered gentlemanly.
Snooping? Sir, I assure you.
Keep vigilant.
Quick, inside. That was too close a call. You, young man, gave me quite a fright. I thought you were one of them. But I realize now why you're here. Same reason I am, I imagine. I imagine? I believe I found something, young man.
Rather impressive contraption, wouldn't you say?
I've seen bigger.
Datura stramonium, or devil's snare as it is commonly called, that goes into the syrup and opium, no less. Revolting. Absolutely sickening.
A favorable way to proceed, wouldn't you agree? Find a way out of here, quickly!
What about the other valves?
Take a wild guess.
Very well.
I'll tear you apart!
Thank you.
Well done, dear boy.
Well done.
Charles Darwin, delighted to make your acquaintance.
Jacob Fry, the pleasure's all mine.
While you were busy wreaking havoc, I found this. It indicates that a sample of every batch has been sent to Lambeth Asylum.
Oh, I wonder if it's visiting hours.
Don't be so hasty, Mr. Fry. Many people work at Lambeth. You wouldn't want to attract unwanted attention.
What was the fun in that?
Not every problem can be solved by blowing things sky high. Sometimes a little discretion is in order. It's getting late. I will meet you at the asylum to continue our investigation.
Doing fine, dude. Steady on. Yeah! Thank you.
most insufferable fellow I have ever had the misfortune to counter.
I have told you before, sir, I had nothing to do with that anonymous article. Nothing, I say.
That is a lie, sir. And you know it.
Bah, I don't have time for this nonsense.
Nonsense! It is my name and reputation you have willfully besmirched, sir. My very name.
Bah! Drive, damn you, drive! Yeah.
That is Richard Owen. A vile, despicable wretch of a man.
Really? I could have sworn you were close friends.
Mr. Owen works at the asylum. He will know who made the syrup. Get him!
Get him!
Help!
Someone!
Is that so hard?
Yes!
Thank you.